health and disease. Health and disease. Let's see what is health, what is disease. Let us see health. Sir, here what is health? So as per some ancient concepts or ancient hypothesis, so the health is defined as the individuals with good humors, they are with good health. Okay, so the individuals with good humors, they are said to be good healthy. Good healthy. Sir, here if you take the ancient approaches like Greek philosophers, if you take, generally the individuals with black bile are said to be more healthy. So if you take the Greek philosopher said that the individuals with the black bile are more healthy. See here, after the discovery of the circulatory system, by whom? William Harvey. So this black bile concept and good humors concept was disproved. Means the individuals with good humors are good health, the individuals with the black bile effect on the health, that was disproved after the discovery of the which one circulatory system by the William Harvey. So when the circulatory system was developed, discovered, when the thermometer was developed and the body temperature came into the progress, so these are all disproved this ancient hypothesis. And if you take the definition of the health, so definition, if you take the health, health is a complete state of well-being physically, mentally well-being, not merely absence of the diseases, and physical fitness is called as health. So health is a state of complete physical, mental well-being of an individual, not merely absence of the disease or physical fitness. Means the individual without physical fitness, without absence of the diseases, cannot be said as healthy. They cannot be said as healthy. Okay, so not only absence of the diseases can be said as, cannot be said as a health. So health means the person must be physically, mentally, socially well-being. It is a complete state of physical, mental, social well-being of an individual. Not only absence of the disease, not only absence of the physical fitness. Means if a person is there, he has no any disease. He has physical fitness, for example. Can be said as he is healthy? No. So there are so many psychological problems are there. So means not only absence of the disease, not only absence of the physical fitness, it is also a complete well-being of the individual physically, mentally, as well as socially. That is called as health. Sir, health is affected by the three things. Health may be affected by three things. So one is infectious diseases. Second one is genetic disorders. So third thing is lifestyle. So these three things will affect the health. So infectious diseases means these are the diseases caused by the parasite. So these are called as infectious diseases if they are caused by the parasite. So infectious diseases. Next, genetic disorders means any change in the DNA fragment or entire chromosome of an individual is called as genetic disorders, which cannot be treated. Next, lifestyle. So lifestyle is also shows impact on the health. Your habit, food habits, what type of food you are taking, what type of water you are taking, your behavior, some habits like smoking, drinking, these are all lifestyles. Lifestyle also shows impact on the health. If you are smoking, your health is damaged. If you are drinking alcohol, your health is affected. So lifestyle, what type of food you are taking, what type of habits you have, so they also impact your health. So these are the three things will affect health: infectious diseases, genetic disorders, and lifestyle. Okay, next thing, let us see disease. Let us see the disease definition of the disease. Sir, any deviation from the normal conditions of the health is called as disease. Means when we are physically, mentally, socially perfect, when a person is physically, mentally, socially perfect, any deviation from that health, so any deviation from the normal health is called as disease. So any deviation from the normal health, normal state of a person is called as disease. Means that person is suffering from the disease. So there are two types of diseases are there, sir. So there are two types of diseases: infectious diseases. Next one is non-infectious diseases. Sir, infectious diseases means which are caused by the parasites. Infectious diseases are caused by what? Parasite. For example, you take malaria, typhoid, tuberculosis, Wuchereriasis or filariasis, ascariasis, amoebiasis. So these are all the diseases which are caused by parasites. If the diseases are caused by the parasites, they are said as infectious parasites. Okay. Next, if you take non-infectious parasites, non-infectious diseases means these are not caused by the parasitic infections. If you take brain abnormalities, kidney problems, heart problems, sugar, these are all not caused by any parasite. These are all only due to the lifestyles. Non-infectious means which are not at all caused by the parasites, which may be depending upon the lifestyle, age of the individual. If you take kidney problems, heart problems, brain abnormalities, liver problems, and genetic disorders also. So infectious are nothing but parasitic infections. Non-infectious means what? You take kidney problems, you take liver problems, you take brain problems, you take heart problems, and genetic disorders also. Genetic disorders are also what? They are also non-infectious disease. So this is about the health and hygiene. So this is about the health. What is health? So health is a complete state of physically, mentally, socially well-being of person. Not only absence of the diseases and physical fitness is called as health. Health is affected by three things: infectious diseases, genetic disorders, lifestyle. And disease, any deviation from the normal health conditions is called as disease. So disease may be two types. Diseases may be two types: infectious diseases and non-infectious diseases. Okay. So infectious diseases are caused by parasites, and non-infectious diseases like kidney problem, liver problem, brain problem, heart problems, and genetic disorders, these are not caused by the parasites. These may be caused by lifestyles.